Half a sheep covering.
The arts of the Etheria. The Etheria.
Within the Anzac War Memorial in Hyde Park, Sydney, you have the slain body fashioned by Rainer Hoff, a Freemason, titled Sacrifice, on the what is really the etheric pillar in the etheric portal sunwell in the centre of the memorial, surrounded, you may notice, by the foliage. And the foliage will often depict a portal way, as can be seen within scenes from World of Warcraft's The Conclave of Four Winds. Indeed, within the Conclave of Four Winds, you can see these structures, possibly figures as well. Really, it doesn't matter as far as the physical aspect goes, but you can see that they are imbued. They are imbued objects, and there are four, and in this case you have the mage in the centre, who is actually perhaps imbued each of those in this case, as per a ritual situation. Now, going back to the Anzac War Memorial in Hyde Park, and if we look up the building, this is a photograph of mine. So up that building on the southeastern corner, you have the naval commander there. And in front of the naval commander, you have the ship's telegraph, which, among other aspects, features the dial, and it features the little lever also that emanates from the centre. The dial is positioned sort of in front of the mason, if you will, as well. And in a way, it could be seen as the chakra sort of emanating within the further fields of light around the participant's body. So the naval commander, positioned high up on the Anzac War Memorial in Hyde Park, is but one of four characters up there. They symbolise, the naval commander obviously being water, would be imbued with the energy of one of the four elements. And they stand in what is known as a catafalque party around, in this case, the dead corpse that lies right in the centre of the memorial. Now, the figure in the centre, the sculpture, is known as Sacrifice. And with the body, you would have the bones right there also. And interestingly enough, within this kind of configuration, you can see those the bones there also positioned in this shot from the Conclave of Four Winds. But you see other configurations with this in masonry and so forth. The structure, catafalque, you can look up the etymology to that. But also, cata can refer to breakdown as well. But you are looking in masonry, and this is what the public and even researchers don't understand, is that you're looking for entities, the light body, and entities actually removing themselves and going into further dimensions and so forth. The public doesn't understand this, but nonetheless, I continue on with these videos. We will now go to the Town Hall, also in Sydney, Australia. And within one of the main rooms there, high up once again, on a further level, if you will, you have the woman, the goddess there, within the scene of industry. And among other aspects there with the beehive symbology, you also have the same sort of like wheel structure there. Now, before I proceed on, the wheel structure would have multiple meanings within occultism and certainly within Freemasonry. But in this video, I'm looking mainly at the aspect of the chakra and the portal. Since we have the more of the wheel look within the town hall there, we will also look to the Taoist Buddhist temple. Within there you can see, in this case, the wheel with the swastika as well. And here in Asia you can see another configuration with them both together there. And certainly I would suggest that among other aspects, the swastika is part and parcel with this portal way. among further aspects. So we've seen this basic symbology now in Hyde Park in Sydney, and again within the Town Hall in Sydney within the windows. And if we go to Tutankhamun's throne and look at various depictions, we can basically see the same configuration there. And as per the dial, the ship's telegraph configuration, we can see the kind of emanation out from the centre with the lotus in this case. Now, this would perhaps remind those who are on the ball that, as Leadbeater puts it, there is a flow that goes through these portal ways, emanating, as it were, from the great architect of the universe. Now, people may liken the great architect with Freemasonry, but of course, the God of the Bible, the Lord of the Bible, if you look at the various quotes with the plumb line and all the rest of it, the plumb line goes part and parcel with the compass and square. They are both great architects. So we can see this flow from the portal entrance, I would suggest. Now, in this depiction from India, you can see that little pillar there with the kind of wheel atop it also. Very similar to what you would see in the Town Hall in Sydney. On this pillar in China, you can see the wheel on the pillar once again. In this more modernistic sculpture in Melbourne on Russell Street, among other aspects, you can see the wheel on there at the base also. Now, for most people viewing this video, you're probably stuck in the physical lock. You see pillars, you just don't compute that they represent light, and that this imagery is representing light, and that there is a reality to it. But nonetheless, with this Ashoka pillar from India, and in fact, it's part of the India's estate emblem. With the pillar, you have the Dharma chakra on the pillar. So that wheel at the side of the pillar would represent light, represent a portal, it's part of the person. There's a whole lot going on. But nonetheless, so yes, on the abacus, you would have the Dharma chakra there. So we'll just have a look at a further few images. Now, in this shot of Vishnu from India, you can see an emanation from that flower once again. Now, this is not coincidence. And if you look further in here at the details down below with what is perhaps a cherubim there due to the scale, you can see the figure holding that little portal way, that chakra portal way once again, this time in the centre of the body, reminding us of what we saw with the naval commander in Sydney, but with the emanation coming from there also. As if, in a way, it's kind of like the cornucopia. And of course, with the cornucopia, you would that would resemble part of the chakra system, with those emanations out into the further kind of light bodies of the human being. In this photograph from Egypt, you can see what appears to be a bit of a study of that portal way, and there are various markings there that are maybe numeric indications of numeric aspects to that portal way. And with that, I think I'll leave it at this for now. I hope you've enjoyed the video.